Minister, I think this is a very profound and very complex piece of legislation and a very, very important subject in relation to sexual crimes. And I want to first start to say that sexual violence of any kind is utterly hideous. And gender-based violence and toxic misogyny are reprehensible in any form. And they exist and they manifest, and unfortunately they are on the rise in society. And the profound effect on the victim is incalculable. Anybody that has been gone through that process of being sexually abused or sexual violence committed against them, that effect stays with them for the rest of their lives. And it will have a profound effect even after when they have children and so forth. But Minister, I want to kind of just look at a different aspect in relation to societal issues around sexual violence and the sexualised nature of our society. And it's not kind of, I wouldn't be kind of radical to say that, you know, there's elements of popular culture that's absolutely insidious, the way it is portrayed in relation to sexualisation of women. It's pretty horrible. How you know, culture and some cultures in relation to popular culture can be that kind of insidious, and I think there's an element of that that's the root cause of sexual crimes and sex and gender-based violence. And even in domestic violence, we've seen over the last 19 months because of the pandemic the profound effects in relation to in the situation, the environment where a woman is subjected to absolutely horrible amount of bullying, intimidation and harassment, and obviously that has a terrible effect on siblings of and children of that person. So it's pretty horrible situation. Just part of the bill, Minister, I would have serious concerns about electronic tagging. I think there is probably no evidence that deters the individual from you know, doing other things, and I think there's not that much evidence in relation to that. In relation to investing in kind of in relation to domestic violence, you know, where, you know, people present themselves, women present themselves, I think there's definitely an argument that there needs to be more provision in relation to that, and that has to be kind of invested in where women present themselves in that situation. Rehabilitation, I think it's a very important thing. As I said, some of the people that have been incarcerated in relation to this have done absolutely the most dreadful crimes. But did they actually, were they born, like, were they kind of, did they, well, how was that the scenario? You know, was that nurture or nature, or was that societal? You know, and I think, you know, was that person born to do that? I don't think so. I think there is definitely room and an opening for rehabilitation and to prevent a person ever actually get that stage. So that's very, very important. There's also training around consent, which is kind of, we have seen this with the Me Too movement. I think it's a very, very important movement where women have come out saying, look, they've been subjected to kind of quite subtle and kind of very kind of, how would you say, very forceful kind of violence and sexual kind of approachments in their workplace. And that's very, very important. We've even seen through the kind of the Women of Honour movement in the Defence Forces, women coming out, I mean, they had come out and, you know, had said this, they were subject to this kind of pretty horrible behaviour. And it's quite absolutely toxic, literally toxic. And this has, as I said, a terrible effect on those that are subjected to this. So, Minister, I understand this is the most serious of issues, but I think I do have serious issues around certain parts of the bill. Thank you.